Outcome 4.1.4, determine the cause of incorrect flow. If a fixed displacement pump operating at a rated RPM will not deliver flow at the outlet, there is something wrong with the pump. This assumes the inlet receives fluid and is not obstructed or open to atmosphere, the reservoir has the correct fluid level, and that the input shaft or drive coupling is not damaged. This indicates the pumping chambers are not sealed, and load pressure causes the pump to recirculate the fluid inside the pump or leak it out of the case drain. The same symptom on a variable displacement vane or piston pump could be caused by a faulty pump compensator or one that has been incorrectly set to a pressure below the load requirements. Still, if the compensator is operating correctly, the problem is the same, that cylinders under load extend and retract slower than cycle times given for the manufacturer's machine. The problem of low flow from the pump may be difficult to troubleshoot, as while the pump may be leaking and other components also may be leaking. Other causes of low flow could be relief valves not fully sealing or other valves allowing fluid to bypass the circuit. Before changing the pump, determine if the low flow condition applies to only one function, multiple functions operated individually, or when multiple functions are operated simultaneously to verify the pump is the cause. The other related question is how much flow can be lost before the flow is considered low flow, and the pump must be changed out. Some mechanics report that if a pump will deliver 70% of the rated volume at load pressure, it is still considered usable. This would be low flow, however, when compared to manufacturer's specifications. So in many cases, changing the pump because of low flow is a judgment call. In these cases, manufacturer's recommendations should be followed. The standard test for pump low flow is to check the flow rate in 500 PSI load increments from 0 PSI to relief valve PSI at rated pump RPM. Figure 4.13 shows a typical schematic for testing a fixed displacement pump with an external drain. Refer to outcome 4.2.1 for more information on pump testing procedures. The restrictor valve in series with the flow meter is used to create back pressure against the pump. A good pump will deliver rated flow throughout the pressure range, whereas a worn pump may deliver rated flow when the system is cold at pressures below 1,000 psi, but the fluid warms up and thins out. The flow will drop off as the pressure is increased. The manufacturer's rated flow considers the slight flow loss as pressure increases, typically 5 to 10% due to internal pump leakage. To make a valid judgment about the pump's condition and whether it should be replaced, the fluid must be at operating temperature. A variable displacement pressure compensated pump may also be tested using the same test configuration as shown for the fixed displacement pump test. A load sensing variable displacement pump would need a different configuration on the test bench to allow for testing due to the complexity of the control. The cause of no flow from a pump is relatively easy to determine because something is definitely wrong. Confirm the no flow condition applies to all functions to verify the pump flow is not simply being diverted. Other potential causes to no flow conditions within the circuits are loss of electrical signals to solenoid operated valves because of faulty connections or interlocks preventing valve actuation. Occasionally, a pump will deliver more than rated flow. The most likely reason for this could be the pump is operating at a higher than rated speed. A second but less obvious reason could be the pump has been replaced with a pump that has more significant displacement. Before deciding that a pump delivers more than the rated output, recheck the specification for rated GPM and then check pump operating RPM. If the pump still delivers more than rated flow at rated pressure, consult with the supplier to determine if it was oversized in the manufacturing or repair process. Let's watch the circuit as it is set in motion. Testing of an open circuit pump would consist of connecting the pump's outlet, inlet, and case drain, if equipped, to the test bench through the selector valves. When testing an open circuit pump, the flow after passing through the cooler is directed back to the reservoir by opening the open circuit bypass valve.